Yesterday we were reading about journey across the Arctic. Okay, the story is about what it's an extract which is about a man who was named as Bjarg Aasland, and he was the first man who crossed the Antarctic poles, North Pole and South Pole, all alone. This is the picture of that man, Bjarg Aasland. Okay, he's a Norwegian. He belongs to Norway, and he was not only an explorer, he was also a writer and a photographer also. Okay, so we have read page number 89. All of you open your books. 90 first you will read, and then I'm going to read. Okay, so you have to start reading from page number 90. I call for a new sledge. Yes, Fatma.
Yes, teacher. I called for a new sledge, and on day 12 it arrived. The delivery unsettled me. The helicopter crew represented home and warmth. Over the next few days, I struggled to regain a sense of purpose. I get small goals. I try to find joy in solitude again. That's the key to success on the ice. The right equipment also helps. I use a mix of the traditional and the high tech. My boots are copies in synthetic material of those worn nearly a century ago by Roald Amundsen while journeying to the South Pole. I navigate with the help.
Yes, Peter, continue.
Yes. Yes, teacher, can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you. By Roald Amundsen.
Hello?
Yes. All the boys, turn on your cameras. All the boys. Noman, Bilal. Okay? Yes, Fatma, continue.
Roald Amundsen, while journeying to the South Pole. I navigate with the help of GPS, and most days I call home on a satellite phone. My sledge is loaded with food and fuel. This time,
Okay, next. Who will read? Raise your hand. Yes, Bilal. Bilal, I have unmuted you.
Yes, teacher. From where?
This time. Page number 90, paragraph number 4. Paragraph number 3, this time.
1 minute. Page number?
Bilal, it's not OPE. We are reading the same chapter which we were reading yesterday. You find the page number, and I'll ask some other student. Page number 90. Okay? Yes. Iman, you can read.
Yes, teacher. I navigate with the help of GPS, and most days I call home on a satellite phone. My sledge is loaded with food and fuel. This time, I have also packed two items no one has used before on an expedition like this. A dry suit so I can swim across meads, and a sail to let the wind pull me along on my skis when conditions are right.
Good. Next, who will read?
To me.
Okay, read now.
From where?
The Arctic is so much. Second last paragraph.
Okay. The Arctic is so much more forbidding than the Antarctic. I am always walking on frozen seawater. There is no land anywhere beneath me. I have to take off my skis and walk through rough sections. It's like scrambling through bomb wreckage. When I find fresh packed ice, I measure its thickness with marks on my ski poles. The data I collect with help the Norwegian Polar Norwegian Polar Institute study global warming. I measured ice in 1994 too. It's thinner now.
I've started to feel the layers of civilization peel away. It takes weeks to find your animal self. I wake up, perform the day's task, sniff the north wind, and automatically pick out the best route and campsites. All without thought, I found the
rhythm.
I think I can do this.
Okay, good, Professor. Now I'm going to read and I'm going to explain. Same page, because 89 page I've explained, just a quick review of the chapter. So basically it's true story, and it's just a short extract which is taken from the journal of Borj Oslan, who crossed from Russia to Canada all alone. Okay, so he is a Norwegian. Basically he belongs to Norway. Right now he looks like this. He's old enough, the first person who crossed the Antarctic alone, the North Pole and the South Pole. Okay, Borj Oslan, a Norwegian polar explorer. Now students, basically in this extract he told that obviously if you are mountaineering, if you are like doing any expedition, yesterday I told you, is a well-organized journey. Mostly you are going on an expedition, mainly in the islands maybe, or on the mountains, okay? So he loved to do the things all alone. That is why he decided to cross the Antarctic and Arctic alone. So he was fully prepared for the expedition. He was energetic, he was motivated, and he was battle tested. What happened? The first day, what happened? On the night, the waves of the Arctic Ocean nearly swallowed up his camp, and he survived. Then he couldn't find the, you know, the snow so that he could melt it for fresh water, because obviously he needed water for cooking, for drinking, and for other things as well. But he didn't give up. He kept on thinking that what should he do? Should he call the chopper? Yesterday I told you chopper is not the chopper in which you grind. This chopper is a helicopter. Or the helicopter could bring the new sledge for him. Because obviously if you're skiing, if you are on the mountains with heavy snow all around you, then you need a sledge to move on it. Without the sledge, you cannot walk. You cannot walk on deep ice. So for this purpose, you need proper sledge. Okay, so that is why he wanted to have a sledge. Professor, turn on your camera. I will not tell this thing again. It's compulsory for the boys that their cameras must be turned on. Okay? Chale. Page number 90, paragraph number 2. I called for a new sledge, and on day 12 it arrived. The delivery unsettled me, like he was disturbed. Okay, so although the sledge arrived, but he was disturbed. The helicopter crew represented home and warmth. Why he was disturbed? Because he wanted to achieve his goal all alone. He didn't want the help of anybody. Okay, so why he was disturbed? Because the helicopter represented home and warmth. That is why. Over the next few days, I struggled to regain a sense of purpose. I set small goals. I tried to find joy in solitude again. Solitude means loneliness. What is the meaning of solitude? Loneliness. All alone. That is key to success on the ice. Obviously, if you are all alone, then you have to keep yourself happy. You have to feel that you have all the power to reach your destination. Bilal, you need to be attentive. Bilal, be attentive. Look at your book.
Your Faisal is drawing.
Faisal, please. Noman, I've sent the notes again. Have you people received the notes? Sir has sent
yes,
to you people.
Sir.
Teacher,
Noman,
I have received yes, the notes, teacher. But you said that you will tell the chapters of the dictation and reading.
Yes.
Yes, I
it
will
wasn't
tell
there.
Okay.
Yes,
I'll tell
it
you
wasn't
today.
Okay. I have I'll not tell. Done.
I have written the syllabus for you people so that if any chapter is missing, you need to complete it. Okay?
So from Noman, where we have to, if any chapter is missing, from where we will get it? It's not on the YouTube.
You have to use your brain then. Okay? Read the chapter, find the answers, and if you have any problem, I don't know, I think that two or three chapters, we started our class from the Great Fire of London. Okay? And I think from the Great Fire of London, you have the notes with you. And I have been sending you the notes. During the, like when we were not having online classes, I sent you the notes, if you remember. Meanings also, just check it out. Sun Swallow and the rays, I have sent all the notes. Okay? So you need to contact your friend. Do you understand? Now, let me first finish, then I will tell you. The right equipment also helps. I use a mix of the traditional and the high tech. Skill, your skill is extremely important. If you are mountaineering, if you are like a good diver or swimmer, then you need to be working on that. You need to be very much vigilant and careful. And so he said that I use a mix of the traditional and the high technology. My boots are copies and synthetic material. Obviously, you are walking on the ice, so your boots need to be very, very durable. Okay? Of those worn nearly a century ago by Roald Amundsen. So, he was using that rubber material, which was used 100 years ago. Century ago means 100 years ago by Roald Amundsen while journeying to the South Pole. So, Roald Amundsen also made a journey to the South Pole and he wore those boots. Okay, so his boots were similar to the boots of Roald Amundsen. I navigate. Navigation is basically to find direction. If you are in the ship, if you are on the sea, so you need to navigate. You cannot find the direction yourself. So he was using that.
Sorry, I am disturbing you. Who is Roald Amundsen?
He was also an explorer. He also, who journeyed across the South Pole 100 years ago. Years ago. Okay? So, I navigate with the help of GPS. GPS, all of you know, which tells you about the position. Basically, can anybody tell me what does GPS stands for? The full form of GPS? Can anybody? Okay, write it down. It's the Global Positioning System. The global position. Faisal, write it down. You need to have a pencil with you, okay? The global positioning system. So obviously people these days also we use the GPS. If we cannot find the direction, if we are going anywhere and we don't know the place where it is, so we use the GPS. It exactly takes us to the place. And most days I call home on a satellite phone. Obviously, he didn't have the mobile phone, so he was using a satellite. My sledge is loaded with food and fuel. So this time he was using a new sledge, which was arrived by the helicopter. And so this time he loaded his sledge with food and fuel. So he was fully prepared for the journey. This time I've also packed two items no one has used before on an expedition like this. A dry suit. So what were the two items which nobody has used? Number one is a dry suit. So I can swim across leads and a sail which you can pull, okay, to let the wind pull me along on my skis when conditions are right. So two things he used. Number one, a dry suit, and number two, a sail. Okay? Okay, so these two things were used by Auslan, Bård Auslan. The Arctic is so much more forbidding than the Antarctic. He had already crossed the Antarctic, now he is crossing the Arctic. So he is saying that the Arctic is so much more forbidding. Forbidding means threatening. I will ask you meaning, because in exercise B we have to do the words meaning. Forbidding means threatening. So he's saying that the Arctic is more dangerous or more threatening than the Antarctic. I'm always walking on frozen sea water. He's walking on the sea. Can you imagine? But obviously, because it's the Arctic zone, it's extremely cold. There is no land anywhere beneath me. I have to take off my skis and walk through rough sections. So because there was no land, so he had to take off his skis and he was walking on not smooth surfaces. The reason is that when you're walking on a smooth surface, that can break. Okay, that is dangerous. So rough surface is easy to walk on. It gives a good grip. It's like scrambling. Scrambling basically means mountaineering. Or over here you can say, okay, scrambling means finding, searching. Through bomb wreckage. After a bomb, what happens? Things explode and lie all over, all around you. Okay, so that is a wreckage. Wreckage means like destroyed things, like destroyed homes, houses, furniture, things like that. So he said that it was like walking on the bomb wreckage. When I find fresh packed ice, I measure its thickness with marks on my ski poles. The data I collect will help the Norwegian Polar Institute study global warming. Now, students, because I've told you that Bård Auslan is a Norwegian, he belongs to Norway. The people who live in Norway are known as Norwegian. We live in Pakistan. We are called Pakistanis. Okay. So he says why he was taking the important notes so that he could give them to the Norwegian Polar Institute. Okay. They can research on them and then they can prepare notes to study global warming. What is global warming? Yes. Bilal, what is global warming? Bilal?
Yes.
What is global warming?
Teacher, global warming is...
Now tell me. What is warming, Bilal?
Yes, teacher.
What is global warming? Yes, Faisal, you tell me. Who knows what is global warming? Nobody knows?
The rise of temperature of the earth.
The rise in temperature of earth is called global warming. Every year, the temperature of the earth is increasing. So that is why he was collecting the data to help the Norwegian Polar Institute to study global warming. I measured ice in 1994 too, when he went to cross the Antarctic pole. At that time, he also measured ice. It's thinner now. In 1994, it was thicker, but now it's thinner. I've started to feel the layers of civilization peel away. Peel away means cut off, taken away. It takes weeks to find your end self. I wake up, perform the day's task, sniff the north wind, and automatically pick out the best route and campsite. So what he was doing, his own imagination, he wake up every day, he performed all the day's tasks. He just sniffed, smelled the nose, where the direction of the wind is coming from, and then he picked his route. I found the rhythm. Rhythm means music. Okay, I think I can do this. So, because this is not the complete portion, if you want to read the whole story, you can go on the internet and you can read about it. Journey Across the Arctic, made by Bård Auslan. Okay, you can read it. You will find the full information. Now, students,
why was he carrying fuel with him?
Better to help him out for cooking purpose, na? Okay. Now, students, these are the question answers. Yesterday, I told you to find the answers. Have you tried to find the answers? जी
यस
वन बाय वन हु विल जस्ट रेज योर हैंड सो दैट एवरीबॉडी कैन हियर यस द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई वाज What difficulties did the author encounter during the first 2 days? Yes, ma'am.
Can I?
Yes.
Page number 89 pe hai. The sledge with all his supplies began to break. Its runners came loose and its Kevlar coating cracked was worn by the sharp edges of new pack ice.
Good. I'll repeat the answer. Please write it down. It's page number 89, paragraph number 1, line number, I think, 5th. So you will write, you will start the question like this. The difficulties faced by the author were the sledge with all his supplies. I've told you, we always write the answer in third person pronoun. We never use I or we or my. You have to use the third person pronoun. He, she, it, they. Okay? So you can write... You can write ke his sledge with all the supplies began to break, its runners came loose, and its Kevlar coating cracked and was worn by the sharp edges of new packed ice. Then you will write, he couldn't find snow to melt for fresh water. You will also write down this, he couldn't find snow to melt for fresh water. Have you done? He couldn't find snow to melt. Yes.
So the sledge to for fresh water. Yes.
Yes. He couldn't find snow to melt for fresh water.
Can you listen to me?
No.
Yes. Bilal, quiet. Yes, Faisal. I'm listening. Speak up. Faisal, I can hear you.
He find snow.
Wait, I'll repeat the answer. Check it. We have to complete the whole exercise, so I can't take that much time. Okay. It's paragraph number 1, line number 5. The sledge with all the supplies began to break. Its runners came loose and its Kevlar coating cracked and was worn by the sharp edges of new packed ice. Till here, then add one more line. He couldn't find snow to melt for fresh water. Now, question number 2. Only birds you have to find. Yes, come on. Yes?
How many chapters? Miss, we have did the chapter Lost in the Snow, Nightmare, and the tribe that survives on chocolate. Yes.
No. We have done till Nightmare. The tribe, we will do it, inshallah, next week or after Eid, maybe.
Okay.
I have basically, Numan, this is the syllabus, I think, till August. Okay, so that is why I've included
that. And Miss, you didn't write about the grammar.
Grammar, I will send again with the other notes. Okay, or I will tell you over here.
Yes, tell.
Now, first of all, let me finish the question answers. Now, students, which words in the passage mean the same as the following? Not calm or relaxed, I've told you. What is the meaning of not calm or relaxed? Fatma?
Yes, teacher.
What is the meaning of not calm or relaxed?
Motivated.
Not calm or relaxed means that improvised.
It's unsettled. Yes, Numan.
Teacher, can I tell the second one?
Okay.
An organized journey with a particular purpose, solo expedition.
Expedition, good. That is correct. Okay, question number three. So first is unsettled. Second is expedition. Students, I will not send these notes. So please note it down. Okay. What does the author mean when he says, I was torn? Yesterday I told you. I was torn.
Can I tell?
No, you people have already told. Some other student? From the boy's side? Yes. Okay, Umema, tell.
He was unable to decide that he should call to a helicopter from Siberia or to order a new sledge.
Or to try again next year.
One second. First, let me repeat this. So, what does the author mean when he says I was torn? He means that he couldn't decide whether to call in a chopper from Siberia to fetch him or should he order another sledge. Okay, this is page number 90, line number one. Call in a chopper from Siberia to fetch him and try again next year, or do I order another sledge? You have to write it in third person pronoun. I think you can do it. Now, question number four. What is the meaning of the idiom a close call? A close call. Other than Umema and Fatma. Yes, Noman. What is the meaning of a close call, Noman?
Barbar Bachna.
You will write this Barbar Bachna in copy. So, a close call, can anybody tell me? Okay. Yes, Iman.
Teacher, he escaped from danger.
To escape from danger, correct. Please mute your mic when you tell the answer. Okay, so that the other students. Waiter, please mute your mic when you tell the answer so that the other students can hear. Now, a close call means a narrow escape. To survive from some bad happening. To survive from some bad happening. Some danger, an accident, okay, that is called a close call. To survive from a bad happening or some dangerous event. Why did the delivery of the new sledge unsettle the author? Yes. Why did it disturb the author?
Can I tell?
Yes.
It disturbed the author because the author wants to cover the journey himself.
And you will write the answer obviously it is why, so you will start the answer from the question. The delivery of the new sledge unsettled the author because it represented home and warmth provided by the helicopter crew. Because it represented home and warmth provided by the crew of the helicopter. Yeah, provided by the helicopter crew. Question number
six. Miss, please repeat your voice. Is coming slow.
I'm speaking loudly. Anyways, I'll repeat it again. Obviously, you start the answer from the question. The delivery of the new sledge unsettled the author because it represented the home and warmth provided by the helicopter crew. Okay, now next question. In what ways is the Arctic more forbidding than the Antarctic? Find this answer. How you can say that the Arctic is more threatening? How can you say that it is?
Can I?
Other than all the answers are, yes, Iman.
The Arctic is so much more forbidding than the Antarctic because he was always walking on frozen seawater. There's no land anywhere beneath him. He has to take off his skis and walk through rough sections.
Correct. That is correct. So the Arctic The Arctic is more forbidding than the Antarctic because he is always walking on frozen seawater. There is no land anywhere beneath him and he has to take off his skis and walk through rough sections. First three lines of the second last paragraph. And because the question is in present tense, in what place is the Arctic? So you will write the answer in present tense. The Arctic is more forbidden because there is, you can simple answer, you can write because there is no land anywhere beneath him and he's always walking on frozen sea. There is frozen seawater, you can write it in this way also. Because there is frozen seawater and there is no land anywhere. It's just like scrambling through bomb wreckage. Okay? Now, how would you interpret the author's observation about the decreased thickness of ice in the Arctic? How would you interpret it?
Because of global warming.
No. How do you interpret? How would you interpret the author's observation? Means what inference you can draw about the author's observation? He said that he measured this thickness with marks on my ski poles. He measured ice in 1994 too. It's thinner now. So how do you interpret? Yes, Sumema?
Because of the global warming, the ice caps melting.
Yes. Because of the global warming, very good, Sumema. Because of the global warming, the ice caps kept on melting. That is why it becomes thinner. Okay? Comment on the difference between the author's tone in the first and the last lines of the excerpt. What was the first line? The first week of the last big solo expedition of my life nearly defeated me. The last line, I think I can do this. So what is the difference? You find out.
Can yes. I tell?
Yes.
Teacher, first he was disappointed, his sledge was broken and he was very sad. And in the end, when he had a new sledge, he thought that I can do, I can cover the journey by my own self. He was enthusiastic.
Determined. And he became enthusiastic. Okay, simple answer. You will write this answer in your own words. Because in the first, he thought that he was defeated. He could not continue his journey. But in the last lines, suggest to us that he became more motivated because he set up new goals and he gathered energy and he thought that I can do this. He can profit. Okay? The delivery of the new sledge gave the author an unsettled feeling because the wrong sledge was delivered. The helicopter was a nuisance to his journey. The crew represented warmth and home. This is easy. Which option?
The crew represented warmth and home.
C.
Third.
That is correct. The crew represented warmth and home. Suitable title, you can choose any. Now, students, quickly, exercise B. Meaning, yesterday I've told you. Okay? One by one, I'm going to ask you. You have to tell me the meanings. Okay? So, we start from who's coming over here, Fatma. Yes, Fatma, excerpt.
Excerpt means like, 1 second, teacher. Okay. Huh. Teacher, excerpt means a small portion of a film, text, music, etc.
Correct. F1 is G. Excerpt means a small portion of a film, text, music. Okay, good, Fatma. Second, Iman. Please mute your mics when you have told. Yes, Iman. Motivated,
enthusiastic and optimistic about doing or achieving something.
Correct. Motivated is option D. Enthusiastic and optimistic about doing or achieving something. Okay. Number three, brutal. Brutal. Umema. Brutal.
Bring something for someone.
No, brutal is J.
Very harsh and unpleasant.
Violent, correct. Okay. Now, Alina Fahad. Alina, scrap.
Scrap? Scrap means bring something for someone.
Can I tell?
Yes.
Use a sharp or hard object to remove something from a surface.
Good. Option A, use a sharp or hard object to remove something from a surface. Okay. Now, Hunan. Hunan, improvise. Improvise. Hunan was not available in yesterday's class. So, Numan, you will tell me. Improvise, Numan.
Improvise hostile and threatening.
No. Do or create can something.
Can I?
Do or create something without preparation. I've told you, when you are doing something, you are not prepared for it, and you are using that. He was using improvised tools. Okay. Numan, can you do the sixth one? Fetch. It's easy. Fetch me a glass of water.
Bring something for someone.
Correct. Yes, Fatma, solitude.
Teacher, solitude means the state or situation of being alone.
Correct. Loneliness. The state or situation of being alone. Navigate. Number 8, Umema.
Plan and direct the course of a ship, aircraft, or other from the transport.
Correct. Navigation to give direction. Forbidding. Alina, forbidding.
Teacher.
Right now I've told you, forbidding. Faisal has gone.
Can I?
And Bilal.
Can I?
Oh, yes, hurry up.
Can I tell? Teacher, hostile and threatening.
Option A, hostile and threatening.
Hostile and threatening. And the last one, wreckage.
I, the remains of it has been badly or destroyed.
Now please check your answers. In the meaning column, I'm repeating. 4, 8, 6, 2, 10, 9, 1, 5, 7, 3. In your homework copies, you are going to write words meanings. You will write the meaning in front of the word. For example, you will write excerpt and you will write its meaning, a small portion of a film, text, or music. Beta, you need to submit your copies. I know that thing. Please make sure that your all work must be covered and must be done, and all of you need to submit. Okay, so that whatever work you have done, I can do the checking. Okay,
so my English B, a lot of left English B work.
Numan, you didn't attend the classes, na? That is why. Why didn't you attend the classes?
I was out of city.
So, okay, I'll tell you something what to do.
Excuse me, teacher.
Can you
tell me a little bit about the chapter rescue? I can't understand it.
Rescue is chapter about a girl. Her name is Miss Falkland. And the chapter started when Miss Falkland was riding a mare and a branch dropped nearby her. And when the branch dropped, it frightened the mare, and mare just started running at a very fast speed. Although Miss Falkland was a very good rider, but she was unable to stop that mare. Okay? So the mare was going towards a creek. There was a creek. It was very deep, and it was, I think, 100 feet. So there were also stones at the end. So the mare was going straight away towards that creek, and there was no way out. So there were the two brothers. One was, I think, Dick Marston, and the other was Jim Marston. So Jim, he made a signal to his brother that you need to rush to hold the mare. Collar the mare means to hold the mare. So Dick Marston, he started running. He just started riding the horse at a very full speed. And luckily, the girl, when the mare reached the edge of the creek, she was saved by Dick Marston. Okay, but the mare was not saved, and the mare tried to stop her.